Izzy!
Aw, you're so cute. Come give me a hug.
Was that a bite?
Oh,
yep. Okay, I felt it there.
Should I put it on my face? Oh, yeah. That'll freak everybody out.
You are not going to die. All right, everybody. Welcome back to Jack's World of Wildlife. Now, we've had a recent success because we were able to film a brown recluse bite video, and so far it's been pretty positively received, which is good. I like that. I like to change people's minds and show them what actually happens so that maybe in their mind, in their mind's eye, they don't see these animals as monsters anymore. Now, as a follow-up video, I've decided to showcase a little more of a well-known spider. Now, what I have in this little plastic container is Latrodectus mactans, which is more commonly referred to as the southern black widow. Now, this is a little female here, and we are going to show you all what exactly all the black widow bite encases. Now, black widows, I'll just give you an overview, a general statement about black widows in general. We have three black widow species currently described in North America, and that's going to be the Latrodectus hesperus, the western black widow, Latrodectus mactans, the southern black widow, of which this one is, and Latrodectus variolus, which is the northern black widow. Now, we also have two other widow species. We have the brown widow, which is invasive, that's Latrodectus geometricus, and then we have the red widow in Florida, which is Latrodectus bishopi. Now, that fancy word, Latrodectus, often is described as being the perfect name for this spider, and that's because Latrodectus is essentially fancy Greek for bites in secret, which refers to the fact that this specific spider's bite is not very painful. Much like the brown recluse, a lot of the symptoms that you experience are going to happen afterward and are going to, a lot of the time, be attributed to the spider, when in actuality, it is bacteria or viruses. So what we are going to do is I'm gonna pop this gal out, and you can come a little closer for this one. So you can see here, we've got our little friend. Ooh, ooh. Easy. She's a little startled, but very, very nice looking spider. Now, black widows have a very strong web, which she's actually already been depositing on my hand. You can see she's crawling back and forth. So she's just trying to get her bearings, figure out what is going on. Now, black widows, again, are arachnids. Look at that. Which means they have 8 legs, and they are actually pretty voracious hunters as well. It's not at all uncommon to see these widow spiders feeding on very large prey, again, because their webbing is so strong, they're able to snag much larger prey. Now, hopefully, if I can get her to descend off of my hand one more time and kind of get her spun around, you can see that red hourglass. On the abdomen, that iconic feature of black widows. Now, this mactans, the southern black widow, does have some dorsal spots on the top of her. Some nice red coloration. But you can see, for the most part, again, she's very docile. She's not being aggressive. She's just trying to figure out what's going on, trying to figure out where she wants to go. See that hourglass? Nice. Thank you for cooperating. But again, these are primarily nervous spiders. They will typically try to run away at any circumstance of danger. So what she's typically gonna do is she's gonna be sitting in her web, minding her own business. And what's gonna happen typically is I'm gonna come up and disturb that web, and she's gonna go pull all the way back into a secret little hole that she has webbed up for herself just to get out of harm's way. Now, I have never been bitten by a black widow before, and I've never been bitten by a neurotoxic spider before. So neurotoxin, talk a little bit about that, is gonna directly affect my nervous system. So essentially what this is gonna do is it's gonna basically tell my body, ouch, don't mess with this again. So a lot of symptoms with black widow bites are gonna be, easy, included but not limited to stomach cramps, abdominal pain, back pain, sickness, kind of queasy feeling. But I don't anticipate it being very dangerous. Now, a lot of places have recorded black widow venom as being 15 times as potent as rattlesnake venom. And when you hear that, you think, well, geez, is it 15 times as dangerous as a rattlesnake? No. Why? Because of quantity. These little spiders have a minute amount of venom that is really not that dangerous. Now, again, don't try this at home. Don't try it outside of your home, where hopefully you have black widow spiders. They're not in your home. But just don't do this. I do this to just show you all that these animals are just not that bad. They're not scary. They're not monsters. I mean, I've been handling this one for the entirety of the time I've been talking, and it has done nothing except be perfectly pleasant. Should I put it on my face? Oh, yeah. That'll freak everybody out. Ooh. I'll try it again. Black widow on my face. Come here. I don't want it to bite me on the face, though. Where'd it go? Still on me? Oh, it's hanging down. There we go. All right. So without further ado, I think we're getting ready to try the black widow bite. Oof. All right, so basically what we're gonna do is hopefully our lighting is good, our angles are good, and I'm gonna try and give the cameraman a little bit of a heads up, in order to get her primed in the right position so he can fully capture what's gonna happen. You got it?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, here we go, team. Here we go, everybody. Oh, easy.
Oh, you're so cute. Come give me a hug.
Okay. No, easy. Oh, easy. Okay, we're gonna try this one more time, folks. Oh. Sometimes they just don't wanna cooperate. It's like a toy. Okay. So I'm gonna do my best to get her ready.
Sweet.
Alright, we're gonna try it. Come on. Oh. Is that a bite? Oh, yep, okay, I felt it there. Gonna see if she, that does hurt a little bit. Yeah, look, you can see that her fangs are inside of me there. Oh, there she goes, she released. All right, so she bit me right there. I will say not immediate pain, but it is definitely starting a roller coaster. Yeah, is she in focus for you?
Mm-hmm.
Perfect. That'll be good on the thumbnail. Black widow bite. Yep, okay. So it's starting to get pretty painful here. So again, neurotoxin, that's telling my body, ouch, owie, that really hurts. Don't make black widows bite you again. Now, I will say, right now, you're probably at home going, what the heck, dude? That's crazy, man. Why would you let a black widow bite you like that, huh? And I'm going to tell you right now, there has never been a recorded death from a United States, North America species of Latrodectus.
Okay, it's 6 a.m. I didn't sleep at all because the pain is just terrible.
You might get a tummy ache.
My lower back is like the most painful it's ever been in my entire life.
You might feel a little dizzy.
I have a headache, my joints hurt, everything's achy. So I'm taking a Epsom salt bath to see if that'll do anything before I try anything else.
Your arm might hurt.
Some ibuprofen didn't do anything.
But you are not going to die.
Now I will mention that this is probably an extreme case, mostly because the Black Widow was biting me for so long. Typically they'll just bite and release. That one was a little smaller, so I thought probably wasn't gonna have that much of a venom yield, and I needed to make sure that it latched on for a little bit longer, and I now realize that this was a miscalculation on my part.
If you are bitten by this spider, and you're for sure that it's a spider, you're having a lot of extreme symptoms, go to the doctor. It'll probably make you feel bad. Look, too, so now, sorry, I'm gonna interrupt myself. See how it's getting red. It's getting red around this spider. So it bit about right here. Now you can see it's starting to get red in this area. It's pretty decent envenomation for a Black Widow. Again, I said bites in secret. Typically, the bite is not very painful. I did experience a little bit of a pinch, pretty similar to the brown recluse bite that we experienced just a few months prior. But yeah, you can certainly see already my skin is inflamed. You can see it's almost all the way out here. So it'll be very, very interesting to see the effects of this bite. Now, I will be updating, like I did with the brown recluse, throughout this journey. This shouldn't last nearly as long. This should last about 6 to 15 hours, and I will let you all know. Actually, look at this. Easy. So what she's actually doing right now, see how she's kind of kicking her butt? So that's defensive webbing. She's actually just trying to spray out some web. But look right there, right where she bit me. It's starting to swell up a little bit, and there's some little bumps on my skin right there, which is super interesting. Now again, Black Widows, not aggressive at all, and really not that dangerous. I know it seems crazy that I go out and do all this. Oh wow, look at it now. I know that it seems crazy that I go out and do all this stuff, but it's because I care about these animals. I love Black Widows. In fact, I'll tell you a little bit about myself. Before I started doing Jackson World Wildlife, I kept a ton of animals. I've maintained and raised anything from venomous snakes to, I had at one point probably over 500 individual Black Widows of all different species that I raised and bred. I kept a lot of different types of ant colonies. I have kept pretty much anything you can think of. Dart frogs, plants, isopods, anything. And I've always been so impressed with the behavior of the Black Widow. And what I mean by that is they are so timid. A lot of venomous snakes almost seem to know they're venomous. They kind of carry their weight, if you will, in that fact. They just basically are saying, hey, don't mess with me. I'm venomous. And if need be, if you really want to get on my bad side, I will defend myself. Black Widows are totally the opposite. It's almost as if they do not know that they are venomous. Take a look at that now. Don't get this mosquito bite, because that's not what from the Black Widow. But look. See if I can steer towards this. Look at that. There's the bite. Can't deny that, YouTube. That's the real thing right now. All of our bite and sting videos are done in one take. Don't bite me on the finger. Easy. And that is because I believe in authenticity. I'm not going to put on a show for you guys. I'm going to tell you, that stings. Oh, easy. Shh. What are you doing? She was trying to, I guess, maybe bite me on the finger, but my skin is too thick. I don't want her to bite me on the finger, and that's mostly because there's not enough muscle to kind of dilute the venom as easy. That's more of an issue with hemotoxic animals, but I just don't want her to bite me on the finger. I'd rather her bite me. That's, again, why we do stings on my arm. Why I do stings. We, the Royal Jack's World of Wildlife, we. I do bites and stings on my arm because that's the safest place to do it. You feel the pain, but it's also not in an area where I could have any tissue damage and things like that, nerve damage, most likely. I mean, sometimes I don't know with some of these things. But look at that. I mean, that's a pretty spider. Right there. There's the bite. So, ooh, easy. She webbed me up there. Look at that. Beautiful spider. Again, black widows hold a special place in my heart, so I used to keep quite a few of them. But I'll probably put her up for now because I don't want to stress her out anymore. And I will keep updating on the sting. Ow! No! She just bit me on the finger. She's a little annoyed, so I'm gonna go ahead and let her go one last time. Starting to sweat on that bite. Well, that's impressive. I hope you guys enjoy these videos because there she goes back in her little container for now. We're going to get her something to eat, too, because she hasn't eaten in a few days. She's a little puny. But we didn't want her to eat right before the video because... Oh, actually, that was a good display of how strong this webbing is. Oh, never mind. It broke that stick. It was too big. because the abdomens are so thin that they can get damaged. During a video like this. But yeah, take a look at that. Localized sweating, bumps, a welt. It's impressive. It's certainly a lot more than what happened initially for the brown recluse bite. However, I'm going to treat it about the same way. I'm going to ride out the effects and I'm going to keep it sterilized. Again, that's very, very important with these bites, is to keep the area clean. I will be, first off, cleaning it with soap and water, and then I have a little topical over-the-counter antibiotic cream that I'll be using. I'm really not planning on using anything else. Maybe pain relief if it gets too bad, because I am planning on sleeping tonight. And if it gets too painful, which it could be, because that I was holding her there for a good long while, and she probably pumped two or three times the amount that she would have just done with just one bite, and she bit me on the finger because she was getting a little annoyed with me. We shall see, but that's pretty interesting. It is getting pretty painful now. I'd say, honestly, at this epicenter, probably almost as bad as a bullet ant, maybe. I mean, it is pretty painful. And again, that's because of the neurotoxin. If you remember from the bullet ant, that venom is just telling my brain, ow, 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 ow. So it's not really doing a whole lot of damage. It's just going to be affecting my nervous system a little more, and more of an extreme kind of bite, because it is going to do a little bit more to me. I think that's the full extent of what it's going to do right now. So we will go ahead and head back to relax in air conditioning, not outside. And I'll be updating on the bite as I see fit. So... stay tuned. Don't click out of the video just yet, because you're gonna wanna see what this does to me. Do I die? Question mark. Will it hurt? Question mark. Do some thumbnail. Ah, ow, so painful. Ah, just kidding. It doesn't hurt that much, but it really does hurt, and it's probably gonna make the rest of my body hurt. It's gonna be pretty achy, I'm assuming. But good stuff, we'll see what happens.
Pretty bad. My back hurts. I can't really walk, so I'm gonna lay down. I took some ibuprofen.
Okay.
I'll go lay down. Swelling's down. This should just be the pain taking its course, but...
how bad does it hurt?
Like... on a scale like 1 to 10?
Yeah.
probably like a 9. I think, oh my God. Just general pain.